Well, I received messages about male perfectors. Well, as you know, in this world, violence is one of the main problems, or actually it's the main problem, violence. I've spoken already about casting out the spirit of violence and how important that is. If you haven't watched those videos, watch them. I also made a prayer on your behalf in which I cast out the spirit of violence from you. Listen to that prayer, agree with it, and pray it yourself on your behalf also. I really believe it, okay? Don't just mumble it after me, agree with it. About male protectors, it comes down to this. Male energy is what keeps this world going. Not in its pure righteous form, in its natural form as Christ intended. It's male energy that has been drained, stolen from men. That's what keeps this whole world system going. Feminine energy is also put in a toxic manner to lure and trap the men. Because once the men are trapped by toxic feminine energy, it's easy to put pressure on the men and they emit all this negative waste. And this negative energy that comes from men is very powerful. Male energy in itself is powerful, especially in its righteous form. But demons cannot steal righteous energy so easily. It is possible to steal some righteous energy from men, but it's very difficult. The easiest way for demons to steal male energy is when they are in the negative. And when someone is in the negative, they're often not aware they're in the negative. And negative, intoxicated male energy leads to predatory, violent behavior towards other men and towards females and towards children. Don't forget about the kids. The kids suffer also. That's why you have a lot of messed up adults here, because not some men either enable their narcissistic, sociopathic wives in abusing their kids, or they would abuse themselves. Doesn't even matter in which order it was. It's wicked. What do we do? People say Christ is the answer. Of course he's the answer. That's why you agree with him and obey him. You walk in his decrees. And if you, as a female believer, you want male protection around you, healthy male energy, then please operate in your natural femininity. If you keep operating in this toxic waste that the world is teaching you, the only thing that will happen is you will make yourself unattractive to men in general, despite how many short skirts you wear. If you don't operate in your natural femininity as a woman, you become unattractive. Men may be triggered by how you look or how you dress, but that's all there is. You become repulsive onto them. A female that doesn't operate according to her kind, according to her nature, is repulsive. And the only type of men that will enjoy being around you are the type of men that shouldn't be around you. And those type of men that would put up with you are the types of men that would turn on you physically and may even kill you if you try to leave them. So, you want male protectors, or just men that operate in a natural masculinity, then operate in your natural femininity. Don't let your emission be in line with what demons want, and at the same time, wonder why you don't have positive influences around you. Now, you're a female. As a female believer, you're a female. So there are certain things a man can stand and do that you can't, because you're a female. Your energy field is different. I understand that. Nevertheless, operate in your natural femininity, please. And this doesn't have much to do with how you dress. It's how you think. It has to do with your thinking, because it's the thinking that directs the emissions that comes from you as a spirit being. Whether you dress modestly, or as pagan Christians call modest, you cover your whole body, or whether you dress, or you wear a burqa, or whether you wear a very short skirt, what it comes down to is the following. Is your emission feminine as a female? If it's feminine as a female, you don't have to make much effort in getting attention from the opposite sex or from others in general, because you operate according to your kind. If you operate against your kind, then you need a lot of compensation, and that compensation will tire you, it will blind you, and it will make you very easy. It will make it very easy for predators to prey on you and devour you. Both male predators as well as female predators, because you have those also. That female predators that act like defect males because they want to be like men. So, that's my answer to the females. Send me messages, talk about male protectors. Operate according to your kind, as Christ intended. And by itself, the right type of males would come around you. But, that's it for now. Remember to agree with Christ and be at peace.